than nervous in the fourth quarter, but a lot of that was
so that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gauden. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. Till next time, we say so long from Atlanta.
Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my last. People view everything different when you're touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's for clout and haters mad. You can never be a subject carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I paid it. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm pacing. I got choices, I'm getting opinions from so many folks to bring the horses. Too many people tell me what I should do, I take it and laugh. They not knowing if I mess up, I can end up falling flat. If I write a bad tweet, lagging in my whole street. If I give them what they want, then I'm gonna be broke in a week. If I tell my baby no, she might get it from the street. If I'm not tough on my son, he might grow up to be weak. What do I do? I'm new to having cameras in my face. What do I do to keep getting the love?
We are about 10 miles or so southwest of downtown Los Angeles at SoFi Stadium in Inglewood. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Atlanta Falcons and the Los Angeles Chargers. To go, Younghoe Koo ready to do the honors, and we are underway in Southern California. On the return, Andre Roberts from his end zone, and he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. First and 10, Herbert. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack.
Come on, let's go.
Grady Jarrett in there to get him. It's a loss of 5. Coming up now on a 2nd and 15 following that sack. A shotgun snap for Herbert. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion, and to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. A big play there for L.A. Pretty good timing. He waited just enough for that post play to develop and laid it right in there.
And you know what a lot of teams do when they decide to throw a post route? Because it's a little bit longer developing play, they max protect. bring everyone in, keep the tight end in, an extra back to make sure the quarterback has time to deliver the football.
They'll run for the first time with Austin Ekeler. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. They've got a first and 10 at the 17. Play fake, and now Herbert to throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Herbert will give this one to Ekeler. And he's gonna lose yards. They take him down at the 26. Just a 1 yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a third and long.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Now it's Herbert. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Brandon Copeland gets him for a loss of 5. He is so tough to handle on the blitz, and that's Exhibit A. Ninth play now, this long opening drive. Can they cash it in on third and goal? Flushed out right. Here's a diving catch right side. Right off the bat, they start with a very solid, methodical 10-play drive.
And you know me, I tend to look at things from the defensive side. They're coming off the field gassed right away. We're in the first drive of the game. So it's not just what happened, but think of the emotion you carry into a game. Then double it with getting a 10-play drive put on you at point score. They're pretty tired right now.
Hopkins with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Ryan and the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their own 23. Throwing to start the drive. Ryan, open man is Kyle Pitts, his tight end. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line. From the 30 on second down, Ryan. He completes this to Russell Gage. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Patterson on the carry. And he's going to get across midfield and into Charger territory. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
The last run got six, now second and four. They run the counter. It's Patterson, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, third and five. Ryan. That's into the hands of Pitts, the tight end. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
First down, Patterson, and he's going to get a solid gain of nine before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
And after that type of a run, there's some talking going on down on the field, but it's not trash talking. The guy who just carried the ball, he's going back and telling his offensive line, great job, keep it up, and we'll break that one soon.
From the 31, Ryan, and he fends him off. Ryan avoiding the hit at the end as he'll slide down with a first down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
They'll run on first down. It's Patterson, and they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Reminder coming up in a couple of minutes' time. We'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman, the coach in our EA Sports studios. They'll have a look back at the next-gen stats from this first half of action. Now they'll throw it with Ryan. Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sacked back at the 29. Credit the sack to Joey Bosa. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out, you see, and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you. You change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability and a sack resulted.
It's Ryan. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. To throw is Ryan. And he's got it. Touchdown. It's Calvin Ridley on the receiving end from Matt Ryan. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. Great corner route there. Not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field, and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
Point after.